We know for PFAS in general, they don't get absorbed very well through the skin, so that's not likely to cause a lot of exposure. So it's really drinking, cooking, those type of things that we recommend considering an alternative if you're over that level. Next slide. So just to wrap up here, just to let you know what we're doing. We're of course working closely with DEQ. We look at all these new results that we get from groundwater, from surface water, from all different sources to see what's happening and what it means for your health. The second bullet, you know, we're very frustrated about the lack of information like everybody else. So we're staying closely in touch with CDC, with EPA, with the National Institute of Environmental Health Sciences, anybody who's doing work in this area. And there is a lot of work. We're not alone here in North Carolina. A lot of work in PFAS. And so we're trying to learn from them about any hot off the press information that can help us understand the health implications. And then we are starting to see some epidemiologic studies getting going. That's where you look at actual people who were exposed and you compare them to people who were not and see what the differences are. And we have some academic partners who are starting to launch those kind of studies. Next is my last slide. We are trying to provide communities with information. So this is, you know, again, really appreciate you coming out to hear from us at these type of sessions. We put a lot of stuff on the website, et cetera, answer a lot of questions directly. And we do have some very smart people from our group who will be out back to answer questions tonight. And then the Secretary's Science Advisory Board was mentioned already, and we are incredibly lucky to have true world leaders in this area in North Carolina and focused on this question right now. So we're working closely with them, giving them everything they need so that they can help us with understanding these health implications. And with that, I will wrap it up so that we can get on to your questions.